Instagram Reels, YouTube Shorts, TikTok even. If you guys are not on the short form content train in 2023, the only way to put it is you're simply missing out on massive opportunities for growth. I have a process for what I do when I go and seek out dope Instagram audios or sound bites that I can use for creating my type of content. That's what I'm gonna show you guys in this video. Don't get me wrong, I definitely wasn't a fan of these short form, quick cut vertical videos, but in the creative space, if you don't adapt, you die. I personally can't stand the tools that Instagram, TikTok, and YouTube Shorts give you for creating Reels, Shorts, and these short form videos. So I'm gonna take you guys through my process for, in this video specifically, just taking viral audios you're gonna find on Instagram and using them and editing them in your software like Premiere Pro or DaVinci Resolve or Final Cut, putting them back in your editing software, creating a dope reel that can go viral, that can get eyes on your content, and then uploading it right back on Instagram the way it was intended to be. I may make a more in-depth video just speaking about my process creating Instagram Reels and YouTube Shorts from top to bottom, including export settings and just what I have found so far to work, because I'm definitely still playing around with my strategy when it comes to YouTube Shorts and Instagram Reels and everything like that. Let me take you guys back onto my PC. I'll show you guys my process for downloading audios and bringing them back into Premiere Pro to create banger reels. Let's go. Now guys, the first thing you want to do is you want to hop on Instagram and you want to find the audio or, you know, song or sound bite that you want to use in your video. So obviously, you know, I have some saved. If you guys want to go scroll through, you know, the explore page or the reels page and find an audio that you guys want to use, that's perfectly fine. Obviously, you know, you can just scroll through or whatever. I don't feel like doing that right now. But like I said, I have some saved, so I'm going to go to my audios. So I actually have that saved in my messages. Another smart thing is if you guys have a second account, you can use that second account to post your reels to so you can check the quality and how it's going to turn out before uploading to your main account. So that's one thing I definitely do. I might do another video. I've done one in the past about that process. So I'm going to go to the messages I have with my second account. So here I have the audio that I'm going to use. Who would you die for? Who would you lie for? Lie for? So like I said, I've already made the reel, but this would be my process. This is exactly what I did when I went to create this reel in the first place. I went here, I got the audio. What you want to do, you want to bring it back and you play the audio through. Who would you die for? Who would you lie for? Lie for? This ain't the Bible, cause I got a rifle, rifle. Don't ever fuck with me, cause I got enemies, I got enemies. Nobody's there for me. So Father, forgive me, for you know that I'm always in it. I take no interest, party here with liquor, fucking up my system. Now guys, as soon as you're done screen recording the audio, what you want to do is you want to take that file and you want to send it to your iCloud drive. I already have it in my iCloud drive. I'm screen recording my phone so you guys can see my process. So I'm gonna take you guys to my iCloud drive. I already have a folder in my iCloud drive called IG Audios. That's where I save my music or my sound bites, and I send it to my iCloud drive. That way I can upload it to my PC. Or if you have a Mac, which I have a Mac as well, you could just airdrop it onto your Mac or whatever, however you want to do it. But I just recommend uploading it to your iCloud drive. It makes it easier. That way you can access it wherever. So I go to IG Audios in that folder. Now I believe the last one it was this one, 130 right here. Now, like I said, guys, I had already done this. So the file is already in my iCloud drive. So I'll play it for you guys back. You can rename it. I recommend renaming it. That way you're aware of the actual file or soundbite that you're using, so you don't get confused if you're gonna be doing this multiple times. I'll name it San Fran Night Reel. What you wanna do is you play it back. I'll show you guys the screen recording of the audio that I use. Who would you die for? Who would you lie for? Lie for? And cool, see, I cut off the screen recording. That's where you want to cut it off for the audio. You want to make sure to get it down to the exact second, because when you get this back onto Instagram, you want it to be lined up with the original audio. Now, let me take you guys back onto my PC so I can bring this file over into Premiere Pro. I'll show you guys kind of what I did to implement that audio that we got off of Instagram by screen recording and we're gonna use that to create the reel in our editing software, Premiere Pro, DaVinci Resolve. It's really all the same stuff, so I'll meet you guys back on my computer. All right, guys, so we're back on my PC, and I'm gonna show you guys the steps that I take to get that audio from my iCloud drive back on or into Premiere Pro. If you have DaVinci Resolve and Final Cut, same process. You guys know how to implement audios. That's not really something you need me to show you how to do. So let me hop onto iCloud drive real quick. I'm in my Reels and Shorts folder. We hop into IG Audios. Like I said, I recommended that you guys rename it so you actually know. So that's right there. This is the actual original file that I used when I was making this reel the first time. You go right there, you wanna hit download. It'll download it to your PC, so do that. Once you download it to your PC, and I'll just show you guys, just so if you really don't know what to do, I can walk you through it from top to bottom. Go to your downloads, there it is, San Fran Night Reel MP4. There it's in my downloads. So once you get it into your downloads, you wanna drag and drop it into Premiere Pro. Now I have my, we'll open up my file that I use for creating my reels right here. Now, as you guys can see, this is the actual project file that I used for this reel. Now, this is the song right here on that line right here that I have highlighted. So if you downloaded that right there, San Fran Night Reel, drag and drop that, boom, right here. I'm not gonna do that just because, like I said, I already made the reel, so I see no point. But drag and drop it right here. And then once you have that in there, like I said, you wanna have it down from the second the song or soundbite starts down to the end, and then you drag it onto your audio track, and boom, you are good to go. You are good to edit whatever you want on that audio, make the reel look however you want, whatever, you can play with it, add other audios. That's what I did. I added some sound design to the reel that I made, and I'll play it back for you guys just so you can hear it. Who would you die for? Who would you lie for? Lie for? This ain't the Bible. I got a rifle, rifle. Don't ever fuck with me, 'cause I got enemies, I got enemies. Nobody's there for me. So Father, forgive me, for you know that I'm always in it. I take no interest, party in with liquor, fucking up my system. So yeah, that's the reel that I made with that audio. Now, like I said, you can throw sound design in there. I'm actually making a whole other video on sound design itself, just because I think that's something that a lot of people overlook. But let me play it back with just the audio, because I exported two versions of this video, one with just the sound design and one with the music included, because I could use the original audio from Instagram and just use my sound design version and use them both, or use just my version with the music and the sound design in one video. I'll play it back and then I'll show you guys how to implement that back on Instagram. Alright, so yeah, not too bad, not too shabby. Nice little late night reel from some footage I had back in San Francisco. So you want to edit, not edit, you want to export that video out. I'm not going to go over export settings in this video. Like I said, I might do a more in-depth video on Instagram Reels specifically, but you want to export that video out. Once it's exported out, what you want to do is you want to send that file back over to your iCloud drive. Now, you know, like I said, head back over to your iCloud drive. I have a folder specifically for all my reels. I named it San Fran, you know, reel with music, and San Fran night reel with sound effects only. Whatever you guys can name it, whatever the hell you want, doesn't really matter. Because once it's on your iCloud drive, now it's on your iPhone, assuming you have an iPhone. Honestly, I don't know how to do it if you don't. Google Drive, I'm sure, works the same way or whatever, but this is specifically with iPhones. Didn't really think about that till now. So once you have it in your iCloud Drive, we're gonna head back over to your phone. So I'll meet you guys over there. All right, guys, I'm back on Instagram, and I'm using the account that I use to test out videos before I make them go public on my main Instagram account, but you guys can do it on your main account, it doesn't matter. You grab that reel that you made over in Premiere Pro or DaVinci or whatever on your computer. Once it's uploaded to your iCloud drive, you want to download that. I'm going to play this back really quick. All right, so this is the version with music. Who would you die for? Who would you lie for? Lie for? Cool. So you want to download that. Boom. You want to hit save video. All right, guys. So once you're back on Instagram, what you want to do is you want to find the audio that we originally downloaded or screen recorded so that we could edit it in Premiere. And once you find it, you want to click use audio. And since we downloaded the version of the video that we made, you want to upload that. That's this one right here. This is the version I made with sound effects and with the song already implemented in there. And this is where you have the option. So if you edited the video correctly, the audio from Instagram should line up perfectly with the audio that you used when you were editing the video in your software. But for me, I noticed it was off by just a few seconds, and that kind of throws off the cuts to the music or whatever. So if it was perfect in that scenario, what you want to do is you want to take the music, you go to your audio, and you just leave the Instagram audio at 100. But for me, it was just off by a little bit. It bothered me. So what I did is you turn down the Instagram audio. You still want to use that audio. You still want to click use audio when we're on Instagram. But you just turn it down to zero. And you turn your audio all the way up. Nobody's there for me. You hit done. Next. And guys, you post it and boom. It will say that you guys used that audio. Because if you have a viral audio, you want to be able to use that so that your reel can get more exposure. Now, I'm not gonna lie, sometimes, and it happens very infrequently, but it does happen, where I think it's like some glitch or something happens when you put the audio down to zero, Instagram must detect that it's not, you know, there's no sound coming from the audio, so it will say that your audio is original. But it's supposed to, once you've posted it, update it and say, you're using this and this audio, and it'll work good. So I've done it a few times, it's only not worked once. That's why this way of doing it is a little bit risky, because if you make a fire reel, you might miss out on that chance for it to get the exposure that you want. That unfortunately happened to me, I was pretty pissed, I'm not gonna lie. But, like I said, if you did it correctly, and the audio lines up with the music perfectly, then you can just go to your audio, turn your audio down, turn the audio that you used in Premiere, or in DaVinci or whatever software you used, and you just turn the Instagram audio all the way up and you're good. That way you don't have to worry about whether or not it's going to show up as the audio being used. So that is how you guys take audios from Instagram reels that are going viral or just specific ones that you guys want to use, and you take it over to your editing software so that you can make the reel that you want to make without having to rely on the pretty terrible tools that Instagram and YouTube Shorts or whatever gives you to make reels. So I hope you guys enjoyed that video. Feel free to let me know if you guys want more tutorials like this. I thought this was very helpful, especially with the explosion of short form content. And I'm kind of experimenting with creating reels and shorts right now too, for growth and just creative outlets. So my name is Jason Morrison, guys. Feel free to hit subscribe if this video was something up your alley. I do a lot of lifestyle storytelling and videography slash filmmaking content. And I'll see you guys in the next one. Deuces.